Okay, so this is second thing. If you take trinominal nomenclature, second one is trinominal nomenclature, sir. Sir, in the trinominal nomenclature, simply trinominal nomenclature is the extension of binomial nomenclature. What happened in the binomial nomenclature? We have selected two words. First word is the genus, second word is the species. But here just we are extending binomial nomenclature. In the trinominal nomenclature, scientific name has three words. How many words are present in the scientific name? Three words. So just first one is the species, genus. Second one is the species. Third one is subspecies. What is the third one? Subspecies. Only subspecies is the third one added to the binomial nomenclature. And if you take, when you are writing subspecies, it also starts with small letter. It also starts with small letter. Let us see some examples. Homo is a genus. Sapiens. Sapiens. So Homo sapiens, sapiens is the scientific name of the man. Homo is the genus, sapiens is the genus, and this sapiens is the subspecies. Next, one more example we can see. Carvus splendens. Splendens. Carvus splendens, splendens. So this is also trinominal nomenclature. This is crow scientific name. India or Pakistan crow, scientific name Carvus splendens, splendens. Okay, so this is about the trinominal nomenclature, sir. So trinominal nomenclature is also very important 2 marks question. So trinominal nomenclature is nothing but extension of binomial nomenclature. In the trinominal nomenclature, scientific name has three words. First one is the genus, second one is the species, third one is the subspecies. And important thing is, subspecies also starts with small letter. We have seen two examples, Homo sapiens sapiens, Carvus splendens splendens. Okay, next, third one is tautonomy. Yeah, sir, what is tautonomy? Tautonomy is the practicing of an animal, naming of an animal, in which both genus name and species name are same. So tautonomy is a practice of naming of an animal in which genus and species names are same. For example, Naja Naja. If you take axis, axis. Okay, sir, if you take the Naja Naja, this is Indian common cobra, sir. Indian common cobra scientific name. So Naja is the genus, Naja is the species. Both genus word and species words are same. So that kind of practice is called as tautonomy. Axis, axis. Axis, axis is the scientific name of spotted deer. It is the scientific name of spotted deer. So this is about the axis, axis. So many are there. If you want to know, Gallus, gallus. Next, Ansia, ansia. Okay, so Vulpes, vulpes. So these are all, both genus and species names are same. Gallus, gallus is the scientific name of the hen. So Ansia, ansia is the scientific name of the snow leopard. Okay, so this is about the tautonomy. In the tautonomy, two names or words, genus and species, are same. So this is about the nomenclature process. So let's see species concept. Let's see species concept. Sir, here, what is species? And what are the characters exhibited by the species? Okay, see here, generally the word species the word species for the first time it was used by the genre scientist. Genre. Who is a scientist coined the word species? Genre. So here genre in the book of Historia Generalis Plantarum. Historia Generalis Plantarum. So genre was the first scientist to use the word species, and meaning of the species is kind or appearance, sir. What is the meaning? Kind or appearance. And he defined species on the basis of common descent. On the basis of common descent. So he defined the species on the basis of common descent. Means the animals are the group of individuals who have common ancestry are called as species. Called as species. Okay. Next, he also defined the species.